to run again.
A planet on the edge.
They cling precariously to the top of what is left of the ice floe. Their fragile grip, the perfect symbol of the tragedy of global warming. Captured on film by Canadian environmentalists, the pair of polar bears look stranded on chunks of broken ice.
Those stranded polar bears on the shrinking Arctic ice, victims of global warming, certainly tugged at the heartstrings. That photo was published not only in the Sunday Telegraph, it made it onto the front page of the New York Times and the International Herald Tribune. It also ran in London's Daily Mail, the Times of London, and Canada's Ottawa Citizen. And that's just to name a few. All used it as evidence of global warming and the imminent demise of the polar bear. But the photo wasn't current. It was 2.5 years old. And it wasn't snapped by Canadian environmentalists. It was taken by an Australian marine biology student on a field trip. And in what month did she take it?
The time of year was August, summer.
Summer, when every year the fringes of the Arctic ice cap melt, regardless of the wider effects of global warming. So were the polar bears stranded?
They did not appear to be in danger. I did not see the bears get on the ice, and I did not see them get off. I cannot say either way if they were stranded or not.
And they didn't appear stranded to Dennis Simard of Environment Canada. He told Canada's National Post...
You have to keep in mind that the bears are not in danger at all. This is a perfect picture for climate change. You have the impression they are in the middle of the ocean and they are going to die. But they were not that far from the coast, and it was possible for them to swim. They are still alive and having fun.
And polar bears are good swimmers. So how did all this come about? Photographer Amanda Bird gave her photo to fellow cruiser Dan Crosby to have a look.
Dan Crosby gave the image to the Canadian Ice Service, who gave the image to Environment Canada, who distributed the image to 7 media agencies, including AP.
Associated Press released the photo 2.5 years after it was taken, on the day the United Nations released its major global warming report. That's where Sydney's Sunday Telegraph got the photo, running it with a story taken from the Daily Mail, as Neil Breen explains.
The photograph represents polar bears standing on ice that's melting. Now, obviously, there's a disputed account of when that was taken now, and maybe it was taken in the Alaskan summer when you would naturally expect ice to melt, but at the time when it was sent to us, Associated Press, in their caption to us, told us that the picture was taken of melting ice caps and to do with global warming, and that it was sent to them by a Canadian ice authority, and we had no reason to question it.
Amanda Bird didn't think her photo necessarily described whether global warming is occurring.
I take neither stand. I simply took the photos. If I released the image myself, it would have been as a striking image, nothing more.
That's not how Al Gore saw it. He used it in a presentation on man-made global warming.
Their habitat is melting, beautiful animals literally being forced off the planet. Mr. Gore said, with the photo on the screen behind him, they're in trouble, got nowhere else to go. Audience members let out gasps of sympathy.
Well, that's because they're bears, and at a distance, they're rather cute.
Jefe, what is a plethora